Hello, good afternoon to all. Yesterday we have discussed regarding teachers' preparation, first topic. Now in that only same continue topic, that is preparation of professional teacher and organizing professional aspects of the teacher preparation program. So whenever you are going for any teaching, so as a professional teacher, which kind of preparation you need to do, and after that, in all over India or in the any type of institution, if the teacher preparation programs are going on, so how as an organization we can organize that program, that we will discuss today. So first one, component of the teaching skills associated with the different stages of the lesson. Whenever you are going to provide any teaching towards the students, so at that time, that how you have to prepare in that different stages. First stage, which is a planning stage. This all things already we have discussed in previous session also, but still we will discuss again. In the planning stage, first thing what you have to plan, that is a writing the instructional objectives. So in the lesson plan also, in that what you are making. So first of all, before planning, you will make the instructional objective or you will make the content objective. So that you only that also you have to make here also, and selecting the content based on that objectives only that your content should go on. So first of all, you have to select the topic what you want to teach to the student. After that, selecting the content or the topic, you have to organize that content. And while organizing that also, first you have to plan whether your resources, books or any journals or the net connectivity or the online material is also available or not. So according to that, you have to organize full of your content and plan in this first stage only, and then selection of audio visual material also, which media you want to use for your effective teaching, that also you have to select first in this planning stage only. After that, introductory stage, that is a creating set for the introducing the lesson and introducing that lesson with the questioning skills. So particularly whatever you are going to, how you want to introduce or how you want to start your sessions. So before that, complete introduction based upon the previous learning experience or how much the students know, from that you have to specifically ask some probing questions. So then only the student may get interest into your teaching and they will know which kind of session you want to going to take. So that is introductory session also you have to plan in this second stage. After that, the presentation stage will start. So in this stage, first of all, structuring classroom questions. So before starting of your lesson or any content, so before starting of that class, you have to ask some general question that should be connected with the previous teaching, and the content maybe they have experienced previously according to this lesson. So that particular relevant question you have to ask and structure. Now fluency in the question, that also you have to learn how to ask the question and how to, it's that fluency should be there, that you have to learn. Then probing question also sometimes you have to ask. Questions delivery and distribution, and after planning of complete question, you have to deliver that question. Then according to them, equal distribution also, you have to ask the question to the different students, and the use of higher order questions. Sometimes from general to specific also you can go, or simple to complex questions you can ask. Then lecturing method, in the lecture you have to start your presentation, and along with the lecture or discussion also you need to explain by giving appropriate examples towards that content. Then discussing, while presenting that content also you can discuss with the students how much they have understood the topic or how much the understanding level of the student, and you have to discuss if any of the topic they are finding any difficulty, you have to discuss with the proper example. Then sometimes the lesson which require these skills also, so that skills specifically you need to demonstrate to the students. Some of the procedure in nursing which require demonstration, so that can be also you can provide to the students. Illustration with the examples which include some concrete thinking or the abstract thinking also. So that kind of examples you can provide to the students. So then their thinking ability also can be improved. Use the teaching aids, stimulation variation also, which is required, because sometimes in the, some of the lessons, if the student find it boring, so they will find out like they will sleepy or like that. So basic some stimulation is required during that continuation of that session. Silence or non-verbal cues, that also which is required. Managerial skills, you have to manage your class throughout the class, and promoting the public participation, because if you are going on the monotonous discussion or any seminar, so students or the public will get bored. So you have to involve them in the discussion and everything. So then only they will get the interest and they will learn faster. Recognizing of the class, you have to identify which are the strengths of the class, which are the weakness of the class, and some of the notorious students or anything. That's completely you have to understand and recognize that class behavior and management of the class. These are all important aspects you have to remember while delivering the class. So these are skills which is required in this presentation of the third stage. Then fourth one, closing stage. So as the final stage of your presentation, which skill you will be required, like achieving the closure, because at this stage the topic will be able to, conclude and everything. So you require the closure of the topic. Plan the repetition also, because after some time the student may forget whatever you have taught them. So plan for repetition also. So how you are going to discuss again that topic, by you can plan like first you read full topic and then only we will discuss again that topic. Giving assignments, that is also important, because relevant assignment and the probing assignment that will encourage the students' creativity or innovations. Evaluating students' progress, so how much, whatever objective, content objective you have prepared, according to that, how much the students has able to learn. So that progress also you need to evaluate by taking exams or test or like that, or by taking Viva also. Diagnosing student hearing difficulties or taking remedial measures. So here at this stage also, some of the students may have problems. So that problems you need to identify and you have to take that remedial measures for that kind of students. The development of teachers' education. Here again, the teacher has acquired complete mastery over the knowledge and could also translate into the practical life. So how that teacher education we need to develop? In India, the importance of the education has always been regarded as a noble task, and the teachers of this country had so much renown and prestige that students from Tibet, China, or even Japan, they came here to study under them. So this is, if you see the history, that is also in that you can say there are so many good teachers were there who were very popular for teaching the students in the ancient history also. So that is teachers' education, that is a very noble profession, and it was from very previous history days. In that, if you see in the history also, or even nowadays, that is the one of the kind of system is there in this teacher education. So monitorial system. Here what happens, the teachers used to give the information training in the art of teaching to their favorite students. We can say the method was referred to as the class monitor method. Here today, nowadays also we are following this system only, that is a class representative. So what, but in the previous days, that class monitor or class representative student, that was the favorite student of the teacher and whom they will provide each and every information. So after that only that monitor or class representative will distribute each and every information to the group members. So that is one of the monitorial system. And second one, which is a teacher's training, how they are provide the training to the teachers for effective teaching to the students. So it was in 1881 to 82 also, the Indian Education Commission for the first time put forward the suggestion for training of the teachers. So from that day also, the teachers has been trained to provide the effective teaching. training schools also should be established at plan from which they can conveniently fulfill the demands for the teacher. And proper arrangement should be made for the setting up of normal schools and training school inspectors from the funds made available to the regional government. So that is also another criteria in that particularly the teachers has to undergo for this basic training to provide the effective teaching in this kind of training schools. And this should be spread over the entire country. There should be separate curricula for graduate or even pre-graduate teachers, and the programs for the there should also be different. Training should be essential prerequisite for the teaching. So before they have to start with the teaching profession, always they have to undergo with this training. So that is also very important. Then teacher education was expansion. After some time, the teacher education has been differently expanded by the different kind of first thing is that is different kind of facilities. So many training centers were upgraded, or the institutions were able to organize this kind of courses, provide the training to the teachers from last many days. So that is or the years, that is training facilities. After that, in-service training also. So because of expansion of even training facilities, it has become possible to bring about an increase in the number of trained teachers. So always in-service training also they are able to provide to the teachers. Educational qualification, which is important. Basically, the school education effective, and it is essential to keep in view educational qualification of the teachers. So that qualification is important. After that, affiliation of the institution. Whenever they are able to provide the training to the teachers, so that institution also should be affiliated with the university, or the other standards should be maintained. So that affiliation is important. And the curriculum reforms. Reform of the curriculum is an important step that is also towards the direction. And the teacher should have the knowledge about teaching method. Not only content knowledge is important here, but how they are going to deliver that knowledge effectively to the student, that is also very important. And the curriculum should be also designed that the teacher has the content knowledge and is trained through corrective teaching. They should have cooperation and assistance of the institutions, even in the schools. And his vacation should be also utilized correctly. So that kind of curriculum should be planned by the university or the institution. And that should be followed during that sessions. Criteria for admission. That is also clearly specified criteria for admission of that training institution should be designed and laid out. And that basis for which could be general mental ability as well as educational achievements of the teacher. Based on that capability, they have to be admitted in the training institution. In-service training also they have to provide. Pre-service training is not the end of the teacher's professional preparation, because it is essential for the teacher to remain in contained touch with the latest methods of the technology and as well as changes in the contained knowledge. So each and every day by day, they have to be a learner, and they have to provide the knowledge on the basis of in-service. They have to upgrade their knowledge daily basis. So that is also should be provided. Training of untrained teachers, that is also important. A training course of 1 to 2 years for the teachers with less than 8 years of experience and even below the 35 years of the age. Correspondence courses are also available nowadays, along with the necessary practical training for the teachers with more than even 8 years of experience and above 35 years of the age. So whatever the teachers who are previously untrained, but nowadays that also training is provided by the ongoing or the continuing nursing education program, or sometimes by the distance learning courses also, they can able to get that kind of training. Organization of teachers education. In that, the teachers training program should be organized in the best possible way. And for that, autonomous state teachers training council should be brought into existence and following functions. So that functions will be providing advice regarding affiliation to the university or the state government. Before starting of that, they have to apply for affiliation, maintaining that standard of the state's training institution, distributing into this training establishment, preparing the curricula for training schools, making arrangement for in-service training, and creating necessary teaching material or literature for the teachers. So that is all thing they have to apply. Qualitative improvement of the teacher's education. So how the quality can be improved? For example, like reorient the subject knowledge, whatever the topic they are going to teach. So again, they have to be reoriented whenever they are applying that knowledge. Vitalizing professional studies. So whatever studies they are doing, that library facility and the tutor facility should be given so they can upgrade their knowledge day by day. Improving methods of teaching or even evaluation also. Not only the teaching method, but evaluation methods should be also reviewed and improvised. Improvement of student teaching, development of special programs or even courses for upgrading of the knowledge of the teacher or even the skills should be upgrade or modify. Revision and improvement of that curriculum. So that all things we can improve in the teachers. Educational preparation for becoming a professional teacher, that you already know what kind of education is required, qualification, master's degree in that area of nursing expertise or with the doctorate in the adult education, credentials with the more publication that is also required, writing or organizing skills, a continuing learner, clinical expertise, depth of nursing knowledge and skill in training and its implication, interest in the subject, enthusiasm in the teaching, skill in working with the adult learners, adequate knowledge about the teaching skills and methods of teaching, and broad-based knowledge. So each and every criteria should be fulfilled before entering into that professional teaching thing. Then preparation of the teacher. This thing also what required, preparation of teaching, which involves classroom and clinical experience to acquire that competency of previously identified. These all things also we have discussed previously. Experience, which in terms of educational teacher preparation courses, focus areas or the doctoral program, they have to apply. They have to undergo for that. Teaching institutes, continuing education, working as a teaching assistant sometimes, orientation programs, they have be conducted before that. Preparation for an expectation of the experience. Teaching competencies for appointment depends upon the mission of the college or university and the school of nursing. Now, organizing the professional aspects of teacher preparation program. So how they can organize that teacher preparation program in any kind of organization. Programming of this professional course is nursing. It's a joint responsibility of the director of continuing nursing education and a dean of school of nursing. So in that nursing specific school or college, the dean who is in the higher authority or the director of that CNE program, they will organize this kind of teacher preparation programs in the organization. Now what is the organization pattern or the chart which we require? In that again, organization chart of that CNE continuing nursing education showing joint responsibility for the continuing nursing education and the formal channels of the communication make possible the optional use of that nursing fall to explore needs of continuing nursing education, to set the priorities, to plan the courses and to teach them. So that channels or that particular employees will engage into that kind of activities. University faculty may be assigned sometimes to continue education in nursing as a part of the regular teaching load and even extra compensation balance. So sometimes they have to organize this kind of CNE programs or continuing nursing education program to upgrade the knowledge of different kind of professional teachers. According to that expertise or their specialty only, they will organize that kind of programs. Then orientation skill training program, that is also one of the example of this professional teacher organization program. So what is happening in this program? You must be have undergone for any previous job before applying for this MSc. So it can be teaching institute or it can be the clinic. So there also you have seen this kind of orientation program or the induction training are going on. So what is that? That is also orientation training, which introduces new employee to the basic aspects of the job. Even in hospital field, if any new nurses are appointed, first the supervisor or in from the HR department, they have discussed with them their job chart, their job description, they will discuss, they will provide the information regarding policies and procedure, fulfillment of objectives, standing orders, policies of institution, everything they will discuss in this induction training program. And it is a well-oriented to her working situations. She will be getting adjusted with the new environment very easily and do the work effectively if she has attended this orientation skill training program. And in this training also, they has to given the development of knowledge as well as skills, sometimes basic skills of nursing, that is also they will taught to the nurses. Now again, management of skills and leadership training, that can be also another part of training program we can apply. For example, for the administration and the senior persons, for the persons who possesses that higher qualification, who is having the chances for promotion in the supervisor, they will be organizing this kind of skill programs or the activities. The authorities will give in-service training to obtain the management skill or even leadership skills order. The supervised institution to achieve the target by teaching goals and preparing the person to solve their problems. Then staff development program, this is also another kind of program that I have taught you. So that staff development program, you can also organize for the training of the teachers. Components orientation, in-service education, continuing education, which includes even self-instruction also, attending some short-term based course, workshops, seminars, presentation of scientific paper presentation and everything. So that is also as a part of staff development program, we need to organize for our teachers. Then the faculty administrator, that you can read from that. That is also as an administrator aspect. So what is their role? What they have to do to improve the abilities or the skills of their teacher or the faculty as an administrator? What is their role? That you can see from this. Then teacher preparation in the classroom management. So again, whenever you have to manage your class, so as for that, which kind of preparation will be required? Instructional approaches for classroom management, that is also which kind of instruction you have to provide to the student, that is important. And address the challenges facing teacher candidates and new teachers in creating positive classroom context. So if you see in nowadays also, or from the history, there are so many challenges the teachers are facing whenever they are want to improve their teaching. So first challenge, that is creating any physical arrangement. So many times the environment or the physical environment that is not appropriate, and they may be affecting for that ineffective teaching. Meaning of efficient use of classroom time includes some transition between various classroom activities, that is also sometimes affecting. Ensuring the nature or quality of the student interaction, sometimes the teacher cannot able to interact properly with the students, and how they are interacting, that can be also not able to understand or like that. Clearly communicating appropriate behavior for particular classroom activities. For example, the student may be expected to interact with one another during cooperative learning, but not during independent work. So that kind of challenges, most of the time if you see student want to interact, but during the group activity only, but they should not be allowed to interact with them during that independent activity. So that kind of activity or the instruction you need to plan in that classroom. These are some rules and regulation you can plan for the classroom before starting off your teaching. Like, rules should be kept to a minimum to allow students to remember them. Rules should contain language also, which should be very simple and appeared to the development level of the students and classroom. Sometimes we are using the language which is student cannot able to understand. So we have to explain each and every information regarding the students in which the language they can able to understand. And rules should be positively stated. Rules should be developed for various situation or the context as needed. Like, for example, physical education class or for the field trip. So what according to the situation, that rules can be modified or that rules should be flexible. Rules should be consistent with the school-wide behavior plan. So in that also, consistency should be maintained according to the each and every student's behavior. If the activities they are doing, so or misbehavior, disciplinary actions, or that instruction should be consistent with all for the all the students. So that can be there. So this is the topic we have discussed. Now in next session we will discuss about the self and peer evaluation. Thank you.